Hello everybody, welcome to Jack Wall Plays Clips of Dover, IL-2, World War II Simulator. We're here in Ramsgate. Let's pull up the map really quickly. Oh, I had just added on there. This here is our airfield. We are west of the Broadstairs, south of Margate, north of Ramsgate. And, yeah, what we're planning on doing today is we're going to fly down to Hawking via the coast. So first things first, we're going to bring our propeller back to fine, full fine. We're going to crack our throttle a little bit, and we are going to leave our radiator about 50%. We need to keep an eye on temperatures, basically. We're going to turn on magnetos 1 and 2, and we are going to open the fuel dock. Then, in true terms, I suppose we would shout clear prop. Clear prop, and then we would hit the start with ignition, which is the letter I, and it sounds like we've got a pretty decent start there. Turn on the reticular illumination. Now, we've got a few things to do here. First of all, we need to wait for these temperatures to rise. But whilst we're doing that, I'm going to have a look at my compass down here. And you can see that north is there, so if I bring around my pit to stop there, and you have to make the judgment now because it's really not that clear. That might be about north, I would say. We're facing probably in the region of 110 degrees right now. We'll have to correct this a little bit later, but for the purpose of now, this is good. What we're going to do is we're going to change our directional gyro to about 110. And we'll play around with that a little bit later, just to get a little bit more organized. Our oil temperature has come up quite nicely. We're going to wait that to get up to about 60, and we're going to wait for the temperature of the water to get up a little bit more. Although we're probably close enough to where I can push off from now. What else is there to talk about? Mixture is set to rich down here. And I don't know if this is rich or not in this position. I think it might be. I think lean is pushed forward. Is there anything written on there to indicate that there might be, but I can't make it out. In any case, we are going to throw our propeller into full, and we're going to move off. Now there's a runway around here somewhere, and I think it's over here to our right. So, checking the operating surfaces, and our rudder is working. We will bring it around just to face down the field. I'm just going to take off beside the runway. I'm not going to go out onto the runway. I'm just going to pick a direction that gives me some distance, and we're going to take off. We've put our flaps down, we have full prop, everything is good, and we're just going to go and push the throttle forward. Airspeed is not alive yet. Airspeed is coming alive now, it looks like. Airspeed is alive. Now we just got to hold the prop up a little bit, try and ride the bounces. We're doing 80, we're coming up to 100, we are airborne. Undercarriage is up, flaps is up, revs are about 28. We're pretty much as high as I want to be on the revs right now. So we're going to bring back the revs a little bit. Our oil temperature is a bit high. So bringing back the revs to about 2600 is good enough. Our water temperature is about maybe 100, which is okay. Our oil temperature is about 90 at the moment. That's about as much as I want. Our revs are 2700. We can open that back to a little bit less. 26 is fine. Don't forget to keep a look around because we are on the ATAG server and we are in our home territory, but it is right in the middle of the war, so we could have some uninvited guests from the skies coming down any minute. So right now we are just flying over Broadstairs, and Margate is just down to the just down here at the lip. Generally on the compass I would expect that we are flying about 200 and something. Let me take a quick look at that. We're about 180, so that seems to be a bit off. We shouldn't be at 180 on our directional. 175 is not right either. South is that way, out over the left wing. Well, this should be... or something like that. So we do have to trim the plane out a little bit now, just so that we're not constantly climbing. I do want to climb a little, but I don't want to climb too aggressively. So this is a Spitfire 1, and I believe it's 1, maybe it's 1A. And what's kind of fairly critical about these engines are understanding the complex engine management, which I believe I'm getting an understanding of now. Essentially, you're trying to balance the revolutions of the engine with the temperatures and the amount of radiator cooling you are giving versus speed. Everybody wants to travel as fast as we possibly can, and that's typically a good thing, particularly in a warbird. However, that puts pressure and stress on the engine, which creates temperature, which needs to be managed, otherwise you burn out your engine. And from the engine's perspective, the water and the oil temperatures are those two down here that I'm highlighting. They need to be managed with a lot of care. And if my understanding is correct, the oil temperatures are going to be managed best by controlling the revolutions of the engine. Your throttle, in other words. And there's a... looks like there's a plane down there, which is a bit ominous. Not sure what that crash is. Don't see anything in the skies, though. Be behind me if there's anything. You'd have seen me coming in. I'm pretty low here. So, engine oil is controlled by the throttle, and the water is controlled by the radiator. And my water is nice, and my engine is good. And my revs are 24, so I can maybe push up. I tried to fly around the 26 when I'm cruising. Now, is that? No, that's just a cloud. You're kind of constantly on the lookout here. We are going to fly the coast. Our height at the moment is a couple of hundred meters, or a couple hundred feet, I think, in this. Yeah, it's feet, so... or is it meters? No, it won't be feet, it'll be meters. Or maybe it's feet. I don't know. What's the altitude here? Feet, yeah, feet. We're 2,300 feet. I said a couple of hundred feet. I was a bit confused there, wasn't I? I don't know what I'm talking about. Well, actually, I'm kind of learning stuff, and I'm getting there. So I am going to make stupid mistakes, but usually when I say something that doesn't sound right, I recognize it. There's another aircraft down there. So, with clear skies, height, I think, will be our advantage. So we will nose up just a little bit. We have a full throttle, so we'll just nose up that way and see if we can climb, and it'd be good to get up into the 8 or 10,000 range. Gives us a perspective. Now our airspeed, we are doing a nice 100 and just a little under 180. Our climb rate is not super fast, but it is steady. And my hands are completely off the throttle. So that's not too bad. And there's the northern coast of France over there, which is pretty true to real life, actually, give or take. So yeah, this is IL-2. Now, we are, after passing down past Sandwich and Deal, and we're coming in around Market's Cliff here. And let's make this a bit smaller, and there's Dover. Right underneath us, that's Dover, and that's the harbour of Dover. That's just appearing and being painted. Convinced we have company here somewhere. And then as we travel on, there's Folkestone down there on that big curve, the second one in the distance, and you've got the White Cliffs all the way down, which is beautifully rendered in Team Fusion 4.0 patch that we're all using on the server here. Now the server is a really cool server, lots of friendly guys. Haven't heard any ladies on here yet, so it is just guys at the moment, but they're pretty welcoming, and yesterday was my first time on the server, and I had a couple of nice conversations with some folks that that have a huge amount of patience, because I spawned in on a different airstrip, and I got lost when I was flying south because I didn't know how to read my compass properly. And yeah, I must have been flying around for about an hour, destroyed a couple of engines, all that kind of thing. So I actually never got to meet up with one player called Pain Angel, cool name, who is, I think, about the opposite as you can get to what his gamer tag sounds like. So I'm looking forward to catching up and flying with Pain Angel, hopefully in the future, soon. There's a couple of Aussie guys that were on the server last night, or it was their night, it was my kind of midday, who were pretty fun to fly with, and they seemed to know what they were doing a little bit, so I was learning a little bit from them. And then in the background yesterday, whilst I wasn't communicating directly, I wasn't involved, there were a whole load of players who were flying cooperative missions. There was one guy who was taking a Blenheim out for a bombing run, and he had a couple of guys in Spitz that were doing close air and top cover support, and basically clearing the way from him and covering his butt as he went in, dropped his bombs successfully, apparently, and came back out. So this guy just popped on, said, "I'm a Blenheim, I'm here at Limp, I'm taking off, I need some air support, all help welcome." And 10 minutes later, he had a little small fighter wing set up, and off they went. So it was really interesting to listen to the radio chatter, because it wasn't just yap, 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 and just stupidness. It was really sensible information that helped them achieve their objective. all the planes that are on here are flown by humans. And contrary to a worry that I had, I suppose, everybody is fair and clean, and the rules are clear up front. So where's the train court? I don't know where that is myself. Tunbridge. I have no idea. Okay, well, we're not going to worry too much about that. We're just going to continue climbing here. We're 7,100. So all these bombers will be... Well, maybe there are some AI in the game, actually, come to think of it. I'm not sure if there isn't. I think there is this campaign that is showing up. I think there are some AI that come in when there's not players online. And I don't know how the mechanic works, but I know for sure that you're as likely to be up against a human player as you are AI. Which is kind of cool. I'm always worried about my six, as they say. That's kind of it. This is flying the Spitfire. This is IL-2. Underneath us right now we have Littlestone. Hawking should be right down there somewhere. I can't see the airport or the runway from that. And we're just going to continue flying the course here. We're just checking our map as we're going down, so Wimmouth is that outcrop in the far distance over there. Wimmington. Hawking and Nymph are underneath us. And up there we have, I think East Church will be just where I'm looking now. It's a good idea to know the map, at least the cardinal points on it, if you like, so that you can get a bearing. Sometimes there's quite a bit of clouds. Today it's relatively clear, so you have good visibility, but sometimes there's a lot more of these clouds, and basically everything is going to look a little bit like I'm about to show you now, where visibility is significantly reduced to what you're looking at now. You can just maybe see the rivers and things. And then you get a flash of a very short opportunity to go and look for the landmark that you know you want to see to confirm where you think you are. And just about when you're looking around and you're thinking, ah, there's that cliff, coastline. I recognize that coastline. That looks like, is that Littlestone or is that Wimmington? And you're thinking, yeah, that's... And then there's clouds coming in, and all of a sudden it's being covered up again. So it really pays off to study the map, literally looking out the window, studying the terrain on the ground. See if you can recognize some signature river shapes, not just the coastline, because you won't always be viewing the coastline from this side. And it won't look as pronounced from the water. You know, that was a lesson from yesterday for me, because I took off, I took off in Maidstone, and I was trying to fly to Hawking, which shouldn't have been a very long flight, but it seemed that I was flying towards Gravesend, or heading up towards London, I think. I wasn't going where I wanted to go anyway, that's for sure. So. Now, my revs have crept up a little bit because I've been not paying attention on the stick here. The temperatures are okay though. And we're flying in the clouds. The basic 6 down here, although I think it's the top kind of 3 are the most ones, although the altimeter is obviously good information, but your airspeed, your orientation, and your climb rate are pretty useful. The rev is probably the gauge that I concentrate on second most, and the temperatures I'm constantly looking at, because on the server it's full realism. Ammunition is limited, complex engine management is turned on, you're as likely to blow your engine if you're too aggressive with it as you are to be shot down by your adversary. But with a little patience and a little time, listen, if I can learn it, there you go. My flying skills are not very good yet. I'm kind of focusing on the basics, but I do feel that I'm ready now to take it to the next level. I have a little bit of offline practice to do against some AI and so on to get a little bit more proficient at positioning my aircraft and choosing. Yesterday I was flying against some bombers and I had 40% hit rate, which I'm not sure is good or bad. They both went down. There were two. I put up two bombers, and I got hit a few times, but nothing critical. But they both went down. I was putting rounds into their engines as best I could, and yeah, 40%. I'm thinking that might be a little bit low. Now, I'm in the clouds here, and my orientation is all over, turning kind of right, and I've been losing ground, and it's so easy in the clouds to just lose your orientation. It's crazy. So those dials in front of you with the mouse, namely, your airspeed is not so important, but this, your artificial horizon, that's the right term, and your climb rate, they are absolutely critical when you're in the clouds and you're not sure where you're ground references. Keep your artificial horizon straight, or if you see, keep the icon of the aircraft just above the parallel bars. If that's the case, then you see your climb rate is going up. And if you've got that set out that way, then the other thing is just to keep your icon and your parallel bars relatively relatively parallel, and then it doesn't mean you're banking left or right too much. We're passing through 11,000, or we're very close to passing through 11,000 feet. This is a bit of a test for me. My climb rate is about 140 now, so it's not the fastest. I'm pulling 2,600 revs. And my engine temperatures are nice and stable. No problems at all on that front. So, kind of gone up to 160, although I am dropping into this. And we're just going to see if we get past these clouds. Are we out over the water yet? We'll be very close to going feet wet, as they say. No, we're not. There's the coastline. And this is typical. You'll usually, in the clouds, you'll get like that quick snapshot, and it'll only be a partial view, and you'll kind of maybe see that headland out there, and you'll think, oh, it's a headland with a small jut just on my side of it. You go here, you start looking, you might have to zoom your map in a little bit, and you see, there it is. There's that headland. We're at Rye. We're actually over here. the west of east of west of Rye, but there's that little jut, and there's the main headland that we just saw. Yeah, there's the big headland, and there's that little jut, and that was just there. And you can you won't be able to see it now, but it's obscured by the clouds. This is a regular thing, and the better you get at being able to understand the physical topography below you and translate that onto your map, the faster you're going to be at identifying exactly where you are. Which is just going to be something that is one less thing to stress you out. Stress in the fun sense, okay? But, you know, if it was just consequence-less fun that you want, then, you know, play single player and turn all the realism off, and then just, you know, you can just have some fun, and that's cool. But if, you know, if you're playing on the server, which is full realism rules, typically against other players, it can be pretty frustrating. The sense of achievement, on the other hand, is pretty amazing. Yesterday I managed to get away from a 109 that took some shots at me, and I'm wondering if I got away or he let me go, and I'm not too arrogant to assume that I got away on my own merit. I think I did everything right, just I wasn't sure if I did enough right, but I still did manage to get away. I had some shots, my engine was damaged, and I managed to fly back to base and land it. And I took that as quite an achievement. I was kind of pleased with myself. So, to the extent of what one's definition of fun is, for me that was fun. For me that was a situation presented itself. I dealt with it. I only panicked a little bit. And I didn't crash the plane, I didn't spin, I didn't blow the engine. Although the engine was damaged, I managed to nurse it home. And I was kind of pleased with that outing. I kind of thought, okay, if that was my rookie outing, and it kind of was, you know, that wasn't bad. You know, I'm living to fight another day, and if that's the statement at the end of the day, then things are pretty okay. That's kind of how I'm evaluating progress presently. Now our engine temperatures are about right. Water is good, fuel, oil is good. My revs are fairly stable, and my speed is about 160 knots, and that's nothing to be worried about. That's about good. I have a little bit of opportunity to boost up, but I'm getting this height because I'm going to just practice an energy dive. I don't know really what I'm doing, but we're going to do it together, and hopefully we're not going to break the plane doing it. 13,000 even is plenty. Now the 109s are much better at diving, but it's not that the Spitfires can't. The Spitfires do have parabolic wing, that was what I was talking about earlier. The Spitfires do have that ability to turn sharper due to the wing design, predominantly, which gives them a turning advantage, but that doesn't give them the speed advantage. I don't think it stops them from the speed advantage, but I think it's just the Messerschmitt wing is just superior for speed. So, if there is, for argument's sake, something down below us there, which there isn't, I haven't looked behind me in a little while, and I'll be flying in a straight line, which is kind of signing your own death sentence in this game. Chop our prop, roll it over, and then just head it down. Our speed is screaming through 240, 280, and then we bring back in power and climb back up. But we're climbing up on the throttle because we don't want to We don't want to overcook. And then we're back up and over. Have I just blown the engine? I haven't. What are we doing now? We're pushing through 240 again. My altitude is screaming down. I'm down to 1100, so that was 2000 lost. And then we'll pull back up. Okay. Let's just, I just stalled again. So our altitude is now, we're passing through 9, through 8. Back through 9. There's the 160, so we'll pull out of there because that's the stall that I'm running into, a stall at 130. I got back to 10,000 or 11,000 maybe. Oh, I got back to 10. Oh, I've damaged my engine. Okay. Crap, I think is the word. So as you can see, I don't know what I'm doing yet. Let's see if we can find an airport that we can, or a runway that we can go and land at. Where am I? Where are we? Where are we? We are cutting the engine out. There is the coastline. I think this is Wilmington here. So there should be right underneath it somewhere. A place to land, and I think that might be it there. Chop the prop and bring it down nice and aggressively. Anybody see an airfield out there? Should be one just about our 10 o'clock somewhere. So the air marshal is not going to be too pleased with me because I keep busting up his engines. Dropped down a bit too quickly there. Should have stayed up a little higher, it would have given me a better opportunity to pick out the airfield. There is one here very close by somewhere. So it's just a case of finding it. Is that it over there? We have a problem. We're gonna have to put down Now, that looks like the place to go. Airspeed is a bit hot though. But we'll burn that off. I'll just kind of try and stall it out here. Whoa, nope. Okay. Now, damn, I think is the first thing I'm going to say. We've saved the plane, so that's the good news. And we learned something, I suppose, and through mistakes we learn. But that wasn't exactly how I had hoped that flight to go. It started off pretty okay, and it ended, I guess, pretty okay, because we're walking away from it in true realism terms. Then I suppose this is not a total, complete disaster. You can see the smoke or something, whatever, burning out there. Around about now, from the houses out there, I'm assuming we would have some people coming out to see what's going on. It'd be fairly important to get this plane out of here, but it is intact. It just needs to replace the engine. I need to go and learn zoom and boom techniques. That's I think my next thing. Okay, well, there you go. Still learning. Until the next time, fly safe.